Volunteering is such an important way to fill in some of the gaps in our community. We're learning today how volunteering is going from RSVP of Dane County. And right now during the pandemic, of course, things have changed a little bit. We'll find out about that. I've got Margie Zetter, Executive Director, and Diana Jost, Assistant Director of RSVP. Thanks for being with us today.
Thanks for inviting us.
Doing these a little bit differently right now, but as is the case for everybody. So we're going to dive in a little bit on how that's going for RSVP of Dane County. But first, for our viewers who are watching who aren't familiar with the programs, give us an overview about what you do.
Well, our program, Retired and Senior Volunteer Program, I always like to say you don't have to be retired and you don't have to be a senior, but you have to want to volunteer. We're one of the oldest RSVPs in the United States. Our program started in 1972. We're under the Corporation for National and Community Service, which is a federal agency, and AmeriCorps is part of their program too. So RSVP and FGP are part of the Senior Corps programs with the corporation. And the idea is that we recruit volunteers age 55 and older to serve in the community. It's a twofold benefit. Through personalized placement, volunteers then are matched with where they'd like to serve, who they'd like to work with, what age group, the location, what are their interests, talents, hobbies, and then what they're doing benefits those that nonprofit and public agencies serve. So it really works to extend the services that nonprofit and public agencies provide in Dane County.
Really important work.
It is, right. About 20 years ago, we added the foster grandparent program. And again, these are volunteers age 55 and older. The difference is that we are targeting low income individuals. And if they're income eligible, they receive a very small stipend and transportation reimbursement and some meal reimbursement. And that just helps them to be able to volunteer.
So let's dive into that a little bit more, because foster grandparents is an incredibly special program. In fact, I was sharing with you on the break, I was just on the website watching a really nice video about what this is doing in our schools and in our communities. So share with us some of the details.
Diana, would you like to?
Foster grandparent program, it's a wonderful program that matches the foster grandparent volunteers one-on-one with students in Dane County, primarily in the Madison Elementary Schools and Reach Dane Head Starts. And they work with students generally 2 hours a day, 2 to 4 hours a day for about 3 to 5 days a week, helping these kids with literacy skills and more important, being a role model and helping them through school. A lot of these students have different kinds of needs that the foster grandparents have are familiar with, and maybe have been through the same circumstances, the same life circumstances. So they really develop a bond between these students.
And I know it's important for the teachers as well, who, you know, oftentimes have 30 children in a class and may not be able to support the special needs of children who might be struggling or falling behind. So a really important gap getting filled in here. I do want to learn more about how you are able to operate right now. Obviously, stay at home and social distancing has changed what you do.
Right. So many of our volunteer stations had to make the decision to close with the safer at home directives. And we want our volunteers to be safe, and our volunteers are in the most vulnerable age group. So we do have some volunteers, for instance, in our driver services program that are still able to serve by delivering meals in Dane County, because we have extra safety precautions built in. For instance, if they go to a person's home with a meal, they can put the meal down in front of the door, ring the doorbell, step back, and maintain the 6-foot required distancing for the program. We also have volunteers that are helping with the Newbridge Food Bridge program that are picking up food from food pantries and delivering them to low-income older adults who can't go to the food pantries themselves. In addition, for those drivers that normally help us with transportation for seniors to medical appointments, We did have to suspend that program as of April 15th because it just was getting too dangerous for our volunteers to have someone in the automobile with them. So fortunately, Dane County is able to pick up the transportation need for essential medical appointments only. But in the interim, we're asking volunteer drivers to make calls to those passengers and home delivered meal clients that they normally helped to have an extra friendly social call with the person and make sure that they're okay.
Thank you very much for joining us today.